What's up, everyone? So today I'm going to be bagging some fry and shipping out some of these blue Moscow fry that I have. Here they are, the Midnight Blue Moscow fry. I have two orders in this little container. It's a nice little, I picked it up from the dollar store. So it was really cheap, obviously, a dollar, but you know. The fry are really easy to see in this kind of tub, and so I'm going to be shipping off one of the groups today. It'll be 25 fry, and I haven't sold the other set yet, but I'll hopefully sell those off soon and get those shipped out. But today I'm going to show y'all how I package these fry, and let's get into it. All right, so first I'm going to use this turkey baster and scoop up some water for the bag. All right, that should be good. So, and then this is what I'll have right here. About 1/3 water to 2/3 air. And so if it lays on this side, there'll be enough water for them. If it lays on this side, there'll be enough water for the fry. Basically, you just wanna make sure that there's enough water that whichever way the bag is oriented, there's enough water for them to be okay. also, you want to make sure there's enough air, which is why it's 1/3 water to 2/3 air. Alright, so now I'm going to use my net. This thing is awesome. It is a 3D shrimp net. It holds its form, so it's really, really great, and it makes it really easy to scoop out fry. I'm going to adjust the camera so you can watch me catch some fry, and then I will continue bagging them up and getting them ready. All right, so I got 1, 2, 3. Twenty-five, twenty-six, and twenty-seven. All right, so I now have 27 fry in my net. And I'm going to adjust the camera real quick and put them into the bag. All right, so I have the 27 fry. I'm now just going to take them and stick them into the bag here real quick. And then I'll just let them all swim out of the net. I shipped 25 plus 2, so that's why I counted out 27. The 2 is in case if there's any dead on arrivals, which there hasn't been any dead on arrivals yet, so basically it's just like an extra 2 fry. But you never know, their accidents happen. Might be left out in the warm or the cold for too long, but I don't know. I shipped all of my fish so far in winter, and now we have the warmer weather, but I think it'll all be good. All right, so now that we have the fry in our bag, I'm gonna be using these little orange rubber bands to tie up the bag, but first you wanna just kinda open up the bag. Some people say, you know, you have to like grab it really quickly, but you don't have to do that. All you need to do is just pinch it off, get a nice firm pinch, and then I'm just gonna gently tighten this, spin it around. You don't wanna give them the ride of their life yet. They're gonna be having that soon enough. All right, so now what I'm gonna do is just trim up some of this bag because I no longer need any of that extra. And then I'm gonna take a little piece of tape. It's going to be hard to do. Take a little piece of tape, make sure this is tightened properly. Going to just tape the top. This will help it from unraveling or any of that kind of stuff, which is the most annoying part about bagging fish sometimes when the bag does not cooperate. So now I'm going to just take the rubber band and I'm going to bring it all the way down to the base. Let's see. I don't know. Let me see if I can. See where, okay. So So I'm gonna bring it down to this area right here. And then you really just want it to be at the bottom. That's where you want the rubber band to form, or to not form, that's where you want it to collect. It's down there at the bottom. This is really hard to do holding it in the air, but we'll get through it. So you just go back and forth like this a couple of times until it starts to give you a decent amount of resistance, indicating that the bag is pretty well off. All right, now I'm gonna fold that top bit over. Wrap this there a couple times. Yep, okay, that'll be the last one. All right, so when you push on there, you see how the knot stops unraveling? I've pushed there, like at first it was a little bit more, and then you push it a little bit and then it kind of stops. That's what you want. So the bag is not super duper inflated where it's like, it's gonna pop if I squeeze it, but it's got a little bit of give to it, you know? So that's what you're looking for. I'm gonna go find my other bags. I'm gonna double bag it, and then we'll put it in the box and prepare the box for shipping. All right, so these are the bags I use. They're 5x20s and they're 2mm poly bags. I use 3mm as well, but I like these 2mm bags because they're nice and long and they just seem to work a little bit better for the fry. What I'm gonna do real quickly is just take some of this shipping tape and tape the corners up. Tape the corners up on the bag so that the fry don't get stuck down here in the corner. So what you do is you just rotate it a little bit, stick some tape on the bottom, pull it up towards the side, and then that'll provide some nice, it'll make the corners a little more friendly for fry. Same thing to this side. So we have, see how the fry can like get in there, and if the bag sits down, they can get stuck. That can't happen on this side. And now we're just going to put the bag, the secondary bag, over the top of the first bag. You take a pencil and you stick it in between the bag and the new bag, and then that'll let some of the air out. All right, so this is the only time that I like to flip it over. I really try to keep this knot above or out of, or not have water on it. So like when I package them, they'll lay on their side a little bit like this. And that'll be good. All right, so now it's really important to always make sure that none of the fry got caught up in that top section. I think all is well. All right, so I use this padded envelope as well as another kind of just a cushion. All right, so I have the fish packed in here. I know that this is the side that I want to be at the top, and then these will go into that box down there. In this box right here, I have some insulation. All right, so one thing I forgot to add is this little fry mop. And yeah, that's how I ship out some fry. If you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. If you want to see more, don't forget to subscribe. And as always, have a good one.